make a really good roast today. I've got chopped up an onion. That's just one big white onion I chopped up. And that was a beef roast that I got at Duke City. And that's just half of the roast that I got. I cut it in half and made two out of it. And I put the other one in the freezer. But that whole roast, this and another half the same size, was only $16, I believe, what it was. So that was a really good deal on roast. Duke City has some really good prices on their meat sometimes. If you have a Duke City in your area, watch their sales flyers for different specials that they have on meat, because they have some really good deals sometimes. It seems to be really tender. I marinated it overnight in this Ziploc bag. I marinated it overnight. I poured a full can of Coke in there. That helps to tenderize it. So I poured Coke in there, and I poured a bunch of different spices in there with it that I like to use. And I put some crushed red pepper. I put some of that in my marinade. A really good flavor, and then I just kind of put it in the refrigerator, left it overnight for about 14 hours or so. It's been in the refrigerator, and before I put it into my pan here, I just kind of mash it around a little bit, give it a little bit of a massage, and then I go ahead and sprinkle my other seasonings. This is just what I used. I used lemon pepper, blackened seasoning, brown sugar, bourbon, Montreal steak, and Famous Dave's steak burger. That's just what I use. I have a lot more spices as well, but that's just the ones I like to use on my beef. And I put it in there. I put this seasoning on both sides, and I put a butter. I put about 2 tablespoons of whole real butter in there, and then I just put my onions in there, and then I put my beef in there, and I just cook my beef. I only flip my beef one time because it makes it more tender that way. So it's been cooking pretty good on that side. Let's look at it. I like it nice and brown, like it's been on the grill. You can see there it's got some nice color to it. So I'm going to go ahead and flip that on over, and I'm going to get the other side browned real good like that. I've got this on high. As high as we go, 400. So I'm going to just flip that over a little bit and brown the other side a little bit. My onions are getting nice and done. And I wish y'all could smell this. It smells so wonderful. So I'm going to go ahead and brown the other side, get it really good and brown, and then I'm going to turn this down to about 250, and I'm going to put my lid on it. Got my lid there. I'm going to put that on it, and then I'm going to let it cook for about 45 minutes to an hour. Just on really low, 200. Probably about 200. I'll put it on about 200 or 250, and I'll let it get nice and done in there, and the onions will get nice and done and tender and just wonderful. And then I'm going to just put my potatoes and my carrots in a separate pan and put them in the oven with some more onions and let them cook that way, because I don't really eat the onions. I mean, I don't really eat the potatoes and the carrots being on a low carb diet. And when you cook your potatoes and your carrots and everything in there, you know, you get some of that the carbohydrates do kind of seep into the rest of your food. So I'm going to cook them in a separate pan and put them in the oven with my cornbread that I'm going to be making. I'm going to make some Mexican cornbread. It's one of my mom's favorite things in the world. So I'm going to make her some Mexican cornbread to go
with. Went ahead and took the onions out of my roast to go in here. I used a couple of cans of whole new potatoes. And what I did was I just drained the juice off of them. I took them out, and on my cutting board, I just cut them in little cubes and used them that way. And then the carrots, I'm using a can of sliced carrots. And don't forget, always smash your cans. We want to take care of those little critters out there that come to our garbage cans at night. Put some more butter in there, and then I'm going to slice up some more onion and put that in there with the roast. And there's my onion, nice pretty white onion. I love white onions, they're just so flavorful. So I used about a half a pack of brown gravy mix and about a half a pack of au jus gravy mix. And I just sprinkled that over my potatoes and my carrots and my onions here in the pan. And I'm just going to pour a little bit of water in there just to give it a little bit of juice. And then I'm going to get my cornbread ready. I've got three skillets here. I'm going to make three batches or three cones of cornbread, Mexican cornbread style, Martha White. It's a good product. And I am using two packages today. Just follow your directions on the package there. A can of cream corn, and you want to mix that together with your package. And I would omit about a quarter of a cup of water because you're going to get that extra water in your cream corn. So then I'm going to sprinkle some peppers in there, some hot peppers.
Potato tops and egg, you know.
And I'm going to get back over here and check those onions. They're looking pretty good. Get my cornbread mix put in the pans there. This is going to be so good. My mom loves this stuff. So just kind of pour it out in the pan there. Get it all nice and even. I sprayed my pans with a little bit of olive oil too, some Pam olive oil before I put it in there. Then you're going to take some cheese. I usually take cheddar and mozzarella and mix it in a little bit with your mixture. Put a little bit on the top of it. And you can use cheese or you can leave the cheese out, whatever you'd like to do. Let's go check this again. Oh my goodness. Oh, that smells so good. Okay, look at there. Oh, those look so good. Yep, see, you just got a little bit of that brown gravy on there. And then I'm going to do some green beans as well. I'm going to do some French-style green beans. Just going to put them in a little pan here. You could put spices in it if you wanted to. You could put bacon strips in it, however you'd like to do it. So my potatoes and my carrots and my onions are ready. My green beans are boiling. So they're about ready. There's my cornbread. It's all finished. You can see it's a little brown on top there. And I go ahead and take them out of there and just slice them up. And then we'll just eat one of these today. Probably not even a whole one. And then I'll just put the rest of them in a Ziploc bag and put them in the refrigerator, and then tomorrow when we eat again, I'll just warm them up in the microwave or in the toaster oven. And there you go, you can see my beef is nice and done. I went ahead and took it out and sliced it up and put it back in there with the onion so that it's easy to eat that way. Oh my goodness, I am ready to eat. There's Miss Lily. I guess she smelled everything. Oh, hey Lily. All right, so here we go. Put it in the sink, and we are ready to eat. Got my plate fixed there. Oh, that looks yummy. I ate just a little bit of the carrots and a little bit of the green beans. Just a little bit. And I'm going to top it off with a nice ginger root beer Zevia. There you go. There's my plate. Thank you guys for watching. I hope you try to make this recipe and enjoy it. And God bless you all. And I will see you on the next video. Thanks for watching.